right.
First, I want y'all to get the shoes.
I got a pair like that.
Yeah, nigga. I had a pair like that shit. It was Easter 75, nigga. They used to call them Buster Brown. Remember Buster Brown? Nah, I'm fucking with you, my G.
Yeah, so no, we were saying the first time I met Meth, I was in the Def Jam office, and he was like, yo, cross the five dibs, yo, dibs. And I was like,
skinking asses.
I was like, yo, I said, thanks, appreciate it. What's your name? He's like, Method Man. I was like, I heard of you, man. Then 3-4 months later, that fucking METHOD was the biggest record on the fucking radio, and then his career went a little better than mine. And I seen you, I said, yo, they blackballed me, Meth. And he was like, they didn't blackball you, R.A. I'm like, no, they blackballed me.
And I didn't know, and this is where I take over the story. I had no fucking idea, so I'm like,
he didn't believe
pining.
They did that.
I'm pining for my dude. I'm like, yeah, I'm the R.A. rugged man on the joint and shit. Got quiet.
And Def Jam.
No. We are not paying for R.A. the Rugged Man. What are you gonna get out of him? It's like, this is the guy that shows his ass on stage with dirty underwears and shit. No, no fucking way.
And I
had to take a step back and shit because at that point in time, they had never told me no. Yeah. You know what I mean? And
it was I'm the only motherfucker. They were like, no.
I had to analyze this shit and shit. And I was more or less like, well, maybe the nigga just, what did he do? Is he fucking crazy or some shit? What the fuck?
That's what they
said.
He's
like, you know what? Safe than sorry. Safe than sorry. And then you know what? My G, I should have did it any fucking way.
Yeah.
And just let it ride out.
Yeah. A lot of rappers should have did it anyway. But and you know what's crazy? Before that happened, he said to me too, he was like, you are not blackballed. You are not blackballed. You didn't believe me.
I had no idea.
I said, I'm blackballed. Trust me.
I had no fucking idea. And honestly, if Def Jam was really worried about my safety, they would not have had me in there recording that quad where Pac got shot.